Boom, boom, boom.
Jacqueline Curls gives chest compressions to the mannequin patient simulator at the University of Florida.
It's been so long.
We're losing.
Okay, 100 beats per minute.
Jacqueline is a 9th grade honors biology teacher, and she is participating in a UF program that educates high school science teachers.
Feel a pulse on his neck, on his wrist, you can feel a pulse.
How research moves from the laboratory bench to the patient bedside.
I love learning, and I think if you can emulate that to the students, I think they will appreciate it a lot more and strive harder, even if they don't care about science.
And getting kids to care about science can be challenging.
The computer is running a three-dimensional version of that anesthesia machine simulation.
That is why the National Center for Research Resources funds programs through Science Education Partnership Awards. These awards help UF's Center for Pre-Collegiate Education and Training offer bench-to-bedside programs for teachers from Florida to work with over 350 science and education researchers at the university.
I think that this is something that we can take from the laboratory community into the classroom, and then these students will get excited about this hands-on approach to science and let them know, hey, there are things happening in the scientific community whether you hear about them or not.
The program helps teachers develop new and exciting lessons and laboratory experiments that will hopefully pique a kid's interest in pursuing the many career choices science offers.
The teachers know how to reach the kids, and so working together in a partnership program really allows us to make a huge difference with the future of science.
So we're going to listen to these heart sounds.
UF researchers hope these heart sounds will help teachers reach students to get them excited about science so everyone can enjoy a future of many more scientific breakthroughs and discoveries. At the University of Florida, I'm Chris Bilowich.